So, after 6 weeks of testimony, dozens of witnesses, and hundreds of pieces of evidence, the 7 men and 5 women of this conflicted and somewhat controversial jury have found Steve Menard, also known as Wahooman, guilty on all counts. The 7 charges included assault and battery, theft and destruction of private property. Menard was sentenced to 3 years probation and remanded to serve in house arrest. The judge's last words to Menard were, and I quote, "Wahooman is finished, and if you are ever caught wearing that uniform again in public, you will assuredly go to prison for a very long time."
I didn't do anything. I was framed. I'm innocent. No, get out of my face with that thing. No,
Despite the conviction, Menard has maintained his innocence.
I'm completely innocent. Not guilty. All right, I'm being framed.
No appeal has been scheduled as of yet, but his attorney indicated that may happen soon. This reporter still has issues with the trial, but ultimately, justice prevailed. This is Sissy Summers reporting live from Fairfax, Virginia, for Novatown News.
I'm telling you right now to get off my property and get away from me. One last warning. That's it, buddy. Get out of here.
Steve!
Hi, Em.
How was your day?
Just like every other day. Lousy.
Wahoo loser man.
Steve, I know it's hard, but at some point you're gonna have to restart your life. It's been almost 6 months.
Restart my life? Restart my life? How? Everyone thinks I'm some common criminal, and I didn't even do anything. It's just not fair.
I know. We've talked about this 100 times. I'm sorry it worked out this way, but...
Oh, you're not sorry. You got exactly what you wanted. Now you're the head coach of the Wahoos, and I'm stuck here under house arrest.
You're right, Steve. You're right. I'm so glad it worked out this way, and I have to take this whole team on all by myself. Go ahead. Feel sorry for yourself for the rest of your life. I wish Wahooman had never happened.
Thank you. first meet is a week away. We need to finalize these ladders. We still have about 10 kids that need to go through time trials.
She should know all about trials.
Guilty as charged. Are you done?
Can they ask who's in charge here?
I am.
I should be.
Whoever, you are hereby officially summons to appear in Fairfax County Court, Division 2, June the 2nd, 2013. Don't be late. Have a nice day.
Summons?
What's a summons?
It's an order to go to court.
What for?
It says the Wahoos are being sued by the NBSL for violating league rules, and they want to kick us out.
I can't believe we're being kicked out.
Neither can I. I want to be a Wahoo forever.
I know. I love the swim team.
This is ludicrous.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Don't worry about it. Nobody's going to kick us out of anything. This is just someone's idea of a bad joke.
This is no joke. This is a real summons.
Come on, guys. Enough standing around. Let's get back in the pool.
You heard him. Get back in the pool. Now!
This is just the beginning.
It's been tough deciding my favorite Wahoo memory, and I think I've got it down to two. My first one was when I was 10 years old. I made my first A meet. It was in breaststroke, and I ended up being the number one swimmer because Stephen Oakes and Jack Johnson were both on vacation. So I get up there, I'm the number one swimmer for Wahoos, and I was all nervous. And then I ended up winning that race, and it was the only win I'd ever gotten for the Wahoos, and that was the only win I ever got for the Wahoos. And that was my first favorite memory. My second favorite memory was meeting one of the best coaches I ever had, and he ended up being one of my best friends I ever had. He was a real Wahoo at the purest form. He was really spirited, really nice guy. Ben Wolfenstein, he's a real mentor to me, and it's sad to see you go this way, but I know you've been missed this year, and you'll be missed for many more years to come.
Memories, they were last. I try to keep it simple, cause I hate goodbyes. I try to keep it simple by telling myself.
My whole Wahoo experience has been so memorable that it's really hard to select two of my favorite memories. But I think my first favorite Wahoo memory was that when I was 4 years old, 4 and 5 years old, and I was a minnow. I would become so anxious before every swim meet, before every B meet, and I would run around the deck, and I was just insufferable. And Andrew Satin, my minnows coach, would have to take me by the hand and take me to every point of the meet throughout the night. So if I had to go to the bathroom, if I had to go to clerk of course, if I had to go to the team area, Andrew Satin was always by my side. And now as a minnows coach, I can look at that in retrospect and be so thankful that none of my minnows were ever the same way. But I'm so thankful for Andrew for all those nights in which he would take me by the hand and take me to every place because I can't even imagine having to do that. But That was my first favorite Wahoo memory. My second favorite Wahoo memory would be when I was given the Coach's Award many years ago by Steve Menard, before his hiatus when he was head coach many years ago. It meant so much to me because I've never been a good swimmer. I've always been a hard worker and someone who tries really hard to swim fast. And I've always loved swimming, and especially being part of the Wahoo. So earning that Coach's Award meant so much to me. It was such a surprise, and I still have it in my bedroom. And I look at it all the time.
Wahoo memory is dressing up every A-meet with a different theme when you're younger, and also waking up every morning, well, every A-meet morning, and getting the gift from the Great Wahoo.
One of my favorite Wahoo memories is last year during El Derecho. All the coaches were setting up for the pool, and Alexis, Noah, and I realized that we needed face paint and body paint. So we drove off at like 10:55 at night, you know, to get it. And we noticed that the sky was really green and it was lightning, but we thought that a transformer went out. So long story short, it was a green sky. The trees looked like they were blowing a 90-degree angle. Rain was everywhere. So we pull up into someone's house. I pull the car barely over. I'm still in the middle of the road. I'm the second one up the steps out of three, even though I was driving. And we bang on the door, and the person comes to the house, and they think that we're crazy. But we say, we swear there's a tornado. So we run to the house. We stay there for a little bit. And then they say, okay, you can go, and we swear that they thought we were crazy. Anyway, so we left, and there was all this stuff everywhere. I had to drive on the right side of the road and the left side of the road, and it was just a total crazy nightmare. But we ended up getting home, and it's probably one of the most distinctive memories I've had.
Memories would probably be when I was 8 years old. One of the few times I ever swam in All-Stars, and I remember this very well because I thought I didn't make All-Stars, so I decided to go to the beach with my family, as already planned. And at the beach I found out that they messed up, so I had to come all the way back from North Carolina to swim in All-Stars, which was awesome. And my sister told me I ruined vacation for the family, and I cried. But my favorite thing about the swim team probably be just the feeling of when you're in a really close race and everyone's swimming really fast, and it comes down to like when you have to wait and check the times, and it comes down to that millisecond, and the feeling of winning that race or winning the meet is just an awesome feeling, and I'm really gonna miss it next year, but it's been a good run.
So don't say goodbye, 'cause you'll never be that far from me. I'm telling myself.
My favorite Wahoo memories would definitely have to be a few years ago when we had this swimathon, and every practice all you would do is just swim as many laps as you could to raise money,
for some sort of foundation, and I remember that I went to all three practices, swam 3.5 hours, did 300 lengths, swam 4.5 miles, and at the end of the year, I got a tiny little trophy of recognition. Even though I wasn't the fastest person on the swim team, I did my little part, and it was a great time.
My favorite Wahoo memory is as an 8 and under, I made it to All-Stars, and the entire week was just a complete blast. Every day we did a new activity in the pool, we got to jump off the lifeguard stands. It was so much fun, and it inspired me to swim for the rest of my swimming career, and I got to drive in Steve's car on the way to All-Stars. It was just a great week.
Being able to go from being a 5-year-old minnow to an 18-year-old minnow's coach. And I remember really loving my minnow's coach, Liz, and I remember all the fun things she would do for us. She would give us lollipops on Fridays, and when we were freezing cold at some of those morning practices, she would take us to the shower to all warm up. And I just love being able to do the same things for my kids and give them lollipops and take them to the shower when they're cold and play games and play in the shallow end. And honestly, I couldn't have asked for anything better than to be a part of the Wahoo.
And in a related story, an unusual case for Menardale involving a swim team that is just out of control. The Wakefield Chapel Wahoos, Wahooman's former swim team, are being sued by their very own swim league, the NVSL, for continued violation of league policies in regards to noise, destruction of property, and blatant disregard of basic good behaviour. Should they prevail, the NVSL will remove one of their icons of the swim league since 1970. More to come as we follow this lawsuit to its conclusion. Reporting live from Fairfax, Virginia, this is Sissy Summers for Novotel News.
What a joke. It's just more lies. We don't do anything worse than any other team in the NVSL. Except maybe Donaldson Run. Okay, maybe Oakton.
Well, joke or not, here's the summons for me and the rest of the team to testify next week.
Testify? Testify? You know, there's something fishy about all this, and I don't smell a Wahoo. I would not be surprised if those jerks who set me up at my trial are behind this somehow.
Well, fishy or not, I have to go, and I know they will grill me about you and the rest of the team. Should I get a lawyer?
Wouldn't make a difference. We're already guilty as charged.
Buddy, you're a boy, man.
big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. You're gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace. Waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
I gave up a weekend with the girls at the beach for this. A swim team? What the heck are we doing in court with these people? Should have gone to cosmetology school, like my mother said.
Gentlemen, we're calling the case of the NVSL versus the Wakefield Chapel Wahoos. Are both sides ready?
Ready for the people, Your Honor.
Ready for the defense, Your Honor.
Thank you. Please proceed.
Your Honor, I will prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that the Wakefield Chapel Wahoos violate every rule in the institution and they deserve to be removed.
He said we're a bad team and they don't want us to swim anymore.
Well, that's ridiculous.
Are you a lawyer? How old are you? You're just a kid.
But I know this team better than any stiff in a suit. I will be representing the Wahoos. Your Honor, based on the evidence that I will present, my client will be proven not guilty.
All right, the prosecution may call its first witness.
The people call Judy Judiger to the stand.
Hello. Oh, hi. Hi, guys.
You claim that you were on the Wahoos?
Yes, for one wonderful summer.
And the coaches always let you swim?
Of course. I love swimming for the Wahoos. They always let everybody swim.
Your Honor, that is a lie, and I can prove it.
A lie? Mr. Smith, what are you talking about? You know I swam for the Wahoos.
But Coach, all I want is one race, just one!
I wish I could, Judy, but you just aren't ready for Division II yet.
All you care about is winning. I quit.
NVSL Rule 2.1.3 states, all children who register for the team must swim in the meets if they are able. And in this case, the coach broke the rules. No more questions.
But I did swim for the Wahoos. Mr. Smith, what are you talking about? Mr. Smith, hello?
I said no more questions. The people called Brian George. And so you served as pool president?
Yes, for 3 years.
And during that time, was the pool ever condemned to be destroyed?
No, never. Our pool's always been a safe place to swim.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, absolutely sure.
Your Honor, I submit into evidence Exhibit B. Roll the tape.
Get out of here! We got schedule to keep! Get out of the way!
We call Emily Menard to the stand.
Yes, I'm the Wahoo's head coach.
And you are married to Steve Menard?
Yes, for 2 years now.
And have you ever seen him violate pool deck rules?
No, he always follows the rules.
Then how do you explain this? Exhibit C, Your Honor.
No questions, Mr. Lazar?
Nothing further.
The people call Michael Craig.
Yes, the seniors decided to leave the team back in 2008.
And why was that?
We wanted to play a different sport. Chess.
Chess? Please! Didn't you leave the team because the team cheated and you didn't want to be part of it anymore?
No, we never cheated!
Sit down, you're not testifying. You may proceed.
Thank you, Your Honor. The people submit Exhibit D into evidence.
The NVSL has accused me of cheating, and they're going to force us to forfeit the meet this Saturday against Virginia Run.
Cheating? How could you do something like this?
I didn't do it. They're just accusing me of it.
Guess we won't need these anymore.
Did I hear that right? We have to forfeit the meet on Saturday?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Blame for something I didn't do.
I heard Steve said you cheated. That's why you have to forfeit.
But that's a lie.
I'm going to Ravensworth.
What about the kids?
I could have gotten the first race. I could have won. I beat Sean Smith again in the head.
Coaches falsifying meet cheats is another example of a team that cheats and has no business being in this league.
Your Honor, the charge was untrue and later dropped.
Overruled!
And you are the team photographer?
Well, yes, you know that.
For how many years?
15.
And did you take this photo?
I did. Yes, I did.
Can you identify the person in this picture?
Yes, this is Ruth Ann Mitchell.
And Ms. Mitchell was in what role with the team?
She was the team rep about 10 years ago.
A team rep? Out of control! Your Honor, I'm submitting this picture as Exhibit E. Did Ms. Mitchell ever raise her voice during a meet in any extraordinary way?
Well, she was very enthusiastic cheering for the team.
Like this?
the witness is excused.
And the people called James Barker to the stand.
Yes, I have been swimming on the Wahoos for 13 years, and I've been a coach for 3.
And during that time, did Steve ever seem unreliable or unstable? Were you ever worried about him?
No, I was never worried about Steve. He was someone we could always count on as the kids.
I don't think so. I don't think so. Your Honor, people submit Exhibit G.
James, what are you doing here so early?
I'm looking for my goggles. Have you seen them anywhere?
Have you checked your forehead lately?
Huh? Thanks, Coach. Hey, what's that man doing while we're in the pool?
James, you don't need goggles. You need glasses. The pool's closed. There's nobody here right now.
Then if you don't believe me, look for yourself.
Who's he yelling at? There's no one in the pool.
Is this heaven?
No, it's Annandale.
Oh, yeah. I remember this place. I loved it all. The hill, the intense competition, the pump room. I would have coached here for nothing. Matter of fact, considering the paychecks, I almost did.
I remember you. You're Ted Mitchell. You used to coach here.
A long time ago.
We like ghosts.
What do you think, kid?
Feel real to me.
Well, then I guess I'm real.
So why are you here?
Steve, don't you know?
There's a lot of things I don't understand lately.
I've come to deliver a message. If you build it, they will come.
So it was you?
No, Steve, not just me. There are others, you know. We're all still part of this magical place. And even though we've moved on, we'll never really leave. Well, I better go. But just remember one thing. Once a Wahoo coach, always a Wahoo coach.
So it was a ghost! I knew it!
Wait! Come back! So what am I supposed to build? Guess it's not a clubhouse. I'll see you at Papa Heights, James.
Okay, Steve.
First I'm hearing things. Now I'm seeing things. I must be cracking up. But that never happened!
Silence! You may step down!
The people call Shannon Smith to the stand.
Is he out of his mind?
Dad, why are you doing this?
Just answer the question.
Yes, I've been a member of the team since I was 5, and now I am a coach.
And during that time, were there any dangerous situations caused by the coaches?
Never. Our coaches have always been careful with the kids.
Then how do you explain this? Your Honor, Exhibit F.
Father, can you show me?
Sure.
Just one, Your Honor. What did we ever do to you?
The people rest, Your Honor.
What a day of riveting testimony here at the Wakefield Chapel Wahoo's trial. The prosecution seems to have an ironclad case built against this team, but tomorrow is another day, and the defense will have their chance to give their side of the story.
That's it. We're finished. Done. The Wahoos are over. They're headed to my same fate, and it's all my fault. If I'd just never been Wahooman. Such a failure.
Steve, you may think you're a failure, but...
Listen, whoever this is, you have nothing to say to me or my wife. Do you hear me? Hello?
Steve, it's James.
Oh.
Can you meet me at the pool?
Why?
Just come, all right?
You know I can't do that. There's a restraining order against me. If I even set 1 foot inside that pool, I can go to jail.
Nobody's here.
But...
You used to capture villains barehanded, with or without the approval of anybody. If you were so sure of what was right back then, what's stopping you from coming now?
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down a road and back again. Your heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off, won't you stand up and take a bow? And if you threw a party, invited everyone you knew, well, you would see the biggest gift would be for me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a friend.
This is where it all began.
Where what began?
Hope, Steve. Hope that I could be better. And not only for myself,
but for all who call this their sanctuary. Steve, when I put on that Wahoo uniform, that Wahoo shirt, when I cheered those cheers, when I swam, who knows, the amount of countless laps, it was all part of a team, a family.
Family? A family? Really?
What kind of family gets kicked out of its own home?
One whose leader has quit trying.
Oh, don't you lecture me. Do you realize how many years I've been on this team? I think it's high time someone else took a stand for once.
But you just can't give up. You were the one who taught me and hundreds of other kids to not give up, to swim that last race, to keep swimming with all our might until that last lap has been swum.
I look up to you as a kid, Steve, as a friend and a coach. You were Wahooman in my eyes long before you put on that mask.
But who even cares what they think?
You know the truth. It's them, the naysayers, the ones who say it can't be done long before we even start, who can't handle the truth.
And this may be your last race, Steve,
but by all that you hold true to this swim team and to the Great Wahoo himself,
finish this race to the last lap.
My last lap was a long time ago. Sorry.
Hey, Steve, you and you alone are the only one with the power to change this. Is this really how you want your story to end?
Hey, James. James, we gotta go clean the pump room. And who was that?
Just some guy.
Come on.
Man, this place always gives me some creeps.
Yeah, especially at night.
Yeah. Do you have any stories?
No, not really, no. Alright, that puts us into the top area.
Yeah.
Let's do it quick.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Steve, you've gotten us into a mess.
You're not gonna believe this.
Wait a minute.
A meat sheet from 1970?
Wait just a minute.
Division 10? Where did this come from? Patrick? Kirk? Kirk? Wait. No.
We have a chance. We're as good as done.
The prosecution's case is all but sewn up. Look at the defense. They have nothing.
Sad that it has to come to this. I love being a Wahoo.
Ready to present your case?
Well?
Yes, Your Honor. The defense calls Prosecutor Patrick Smith to the stand.
Your Honor, this is highly irregular.
Your Honor, I need his testimony to prove my client's innocence.
I'll allow it.
State your full name.
Patrick Michael Smith.
And what is your line of work?
Attorney at law.
How many years have you been practicing law, Mr. Smith?
About 25 years.
And in those 25 years, have you ever held any other jobs?
No, I never have.
So you're telling the court that you've been a lawyer for all these years?
Yes, I have.
Mr. Lazar, get to the point.
Yes, Your Honor. Then why does the Virginia State Bar Association have no record of you? Ever?
A computer error.
Oh, really? So how do you explain this?
You lowly worms, get your money and line up. Now!
There was a one summer that I worked as a pool inspector. Yeah, I forgot.
You forgot? You mean you lied. You have never been a lawyer.
That's not true.
Isn't it true that not only have you never been a lawyer, or even a pool inspector, but rather a cold and calculating enemy of the Wahoos, who has tried his best to destroy this team and his coaches since you were a boy?
No!
Isn't it true that you even sacrificed your own son to try and prove you belong on the Wahoos?
Disqualified for unsportsmanlike conduct.
What do you mean? I blew these guys away. What's the question?
What's the matter with you?
You need some glasses or something.
You're pathetic. I wish I wasn't your son.
No! Isn't it true that you posed as a pool inspector so you could get Steve Menard fired and close down the pool?
Menard, get over here! This is the worst water I have ever seen. This is the worst pool I've ever seen. You are the worst manager I've ever seen. I'm gonna make sure that you never work at any pool in this business again. Mr. D, you may proceed.
No! Isn't it true, Mr. Smith, that you once wore a frilly grass skirt to try and become the Wahoo idol and lost?
Tiny bubbles make me warm all over.
No!
And Mr. Smith, isn't it true that the real reason you have always hated the Whos down in Whoville
is because you were never good enough to be a Wahoo?
Stop it! Stop it! Lies! All lies!
Mr. Lazar, stop badgering the witness. Mr. Smith's answered enough questions.
I suppose you have. Haven't you? Kirk?
What did you say?
Kirk. Kirkpatrick Smith, officially a member of the Wakefield Chapel Wahoos in the summer of 1970. Your Honor, I bring to you Exhibit A to the case. On this document, it shows the name of Kirkpatrick Smith. He is that man. He has framed this respectable organization and has been terrorizing kids for years. Not to mention, he's a thief.
No! No, I just took a few.
A few? A few?
A trial, not a pep rally. Kirk, after all these years, you finally know who you are. Kirkpatrick Smith.
Yes, I admit it. It's me, Kirk, your nemesis. The one you would tell stories about to keep kids out of the pump room. I've lived there for many years, hating the Whos.
Why hate us, Kirk? What did we ever do to you?
It was the summer of 1970. It was my first pep rally. I was really excited. And then someone touched my shoulder and said, "Sorry, Smith, you can't be on the team."
But I never said that. I never said you couldn't be on the team. I said you were on the B team. We always wondered why you didn't come back.
Kirk. Anyone is welcome to the Wahoos. You know that. Why did you wait until your son was on the team to come back to us?
The truth?
Yes. We want the truth.
I never got my baby Wahoo.
Join us and put all of this behind you.
You all are guilty! Guilty! Guilty!
Look, it's him!
The evil pool inspector!
I told you not to come here!
We had a deal to get rid of—
The deal is off. You can't blackmail me anymore. They already know who I am.
Mr. Menard, they should lock you in the prison and throw away the key.
And this is my courtroom, mister. Bailiff, remove that man.
Guilty, 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 guilty.
Your Honor, I can only say that I was wrong. And I'm so sorry. And I throw myself on the mercy of the court.
Based on the newfound evidence presented today in this courtroom,
it's quite obvious that good people have been wronged. All charges against Wakefield Chaplain Steve Menard are hereby dropped. Case dismissed.
Chapel Wahoo's cleared of all fraudulent charges, and Steve Menard no longer under house arrest, it will be said once again that once a Wahoo, always a Wahoo. For in the land of Wakefield Chapel, this shall ring true for generations of swimmers to come. This is Sissy Summers, reporting live from Fairfax, Virginia, wishing each and every one of you a very pleasant evening.
Don't be afraid. Stand and show your truth.
Ah, hey, James.
Hey, Steve. Just wanted to drop by real quick and say I'm really glad you stuck with us. Finished the last lap.
It's good to be back, man. Good to be back.
It's a really cool blanket.
Thanks. Mom made it. It's all the old Wahoo t-shirts.
That's awesome. I should tell my mom about that. Wait, what's that?
I have no idea.
Well, hey, I gotta go. I'll see you tomorrow at practice.
All right, man. Thanks for coming by.
No problem.
Steve, you embarked upon a great journey last year and set out to make the world a better place. And you paid a great sacrifice to do so. The challenges you faced were more than you could have ever imagined. And that chapter in your life is now complete. Yes, you became a hero in the eyes of many. But what made you a true superhero was what you did today. You gave a man another chance. Even after you knew the truth about Kirk, you remembered that this team is a family. And that once a Wahoo, always a Wahoo. Never more truthful words could ever be spoken. I know that I leave this team in good hands, and that the spirit of the Wahoos will never fade away. The Great Wahoo.
Time to go win a championship.
Place full of good cheer.